Good morning, my dear students. Today class we are going to perform slump contest for the public. So for that purpose, first we have to collect the materials. The first one here, if you observe, all the materials and equipments are ready to perform the slump contest. So the first one here, if you observe in this tray, this is the cement and this is the sand and this is the coarse aggregate. Okay, if coming to the cement, we take a OPC 53 grade cement and this is the fine aggregate, it is below 4.75 mm river sand, and this is the coarse aggregate, mix of 20 mm and also 12 mm. And here in the bucket, you observe the potable water, and this is the beaker. If you observe the beaker to measure the water, and here if you observe, this is a tray to mix the concrete, and to mix the concrete we will use a trowel, especially for the mixing of concrete. And if you want to pour in any equipment, we will use this scoop, and for the mixing purposes, for cleaning purposes, we use this shovel for the mixing of concrete. So now coming to the slump cone apparatus, if you observe here, this is the slump cone apparatus, and this slump cone apparatus, the top diameter is 10 cm and bottom diameter is 20 cm and height of this slump cone is 30 cm. Okay, this is where we will perform our slump cone test to know the workability of concrete. And if you observe one more thing, this is a tamping rod. Once the concrete is mixed, finished, we have to pour in this slump cone apparatus. So by four layers, we have to fill this slump cone, and we have to give to 25 blows, that means 25 stroke at each layer. Like that, we have to perform four layers. This is the method of a slump cone test. For the calculation of cement and also coarse aggregate, fine aggregate, first we have to calculate the volume of the frustum, whatever we are using in the slump cone test. So once, maybe if you calculate this size, maybe top diameter is 10 cm and bottom diameter is 20 cm and height of the slump cone apparatus is 30 cm, for the volume you will get 0.055 cubic meter. So generally when you are So once if you find out the volume of this frustum, maybe you will get 0.0055 cubic meter. So if you finish that one, for that purpose we have to calculate the cement fine aggregate and coarse aggregate. Now we are mixing the concrete, we are taking the grade of concrete is M20 grade concrete. The gradation ingredients are cement fine aggregate and coarse aggregate and water. The mix proportion is 1:1.5:3. So as per the code book 1062/2009, the mixed design, the cement content for 1 cubic meter, we are taking the 300 kg per cubic meter, and also the fine aggregate is 450 kg per meter cube, and also coarse aggregate is 900 kg per cubic meter, and water cement ratio we take in 0.48. So based on water cement ratio, we got the water also. So that is for 1 cubic meter. From that, we have to take the 0.0055 cubic meter, we will calculate the materials, then we will mix the concrete. So the cement fine aggregate, coarse aggregate, we for weighing of that one, we have one weighing machine, I will show you. Here you will calculate all the weights of your materials. Okay, this is the weighing machine. And now we will observe how we will start the concrete mixing. Start the concrete mixing.
Start.
So now for mixing of concrete, first we have start with the coarse aggregate. So this is a coarse aggregate, mix of 20 mm aggregate and also 12 mm aggregate, that is 60-40 ratio. So now we are adding the fine aggregate, that is a river sand. So once if you add the river sand, so after that we have to add the cement.
So always please use gloves while mixing the concrete for the safety purpose. And if you maybe once at the time of mixing cement, use mask also. So before this, your slump cone apparatus, that is the first step. So now by using the shovel, we are mixing the concrete. So you have to mix thoroughly. This is the mixing process of concrete before adding into the water. Now we are adding the water. So for that purpose, take the water in the beaker. So measure as per the mix proportion, as per the grade of concrete. And now once if you pour into the water, so after that you have to mix the concrete materials by using the shovel. So now we are mixing the concrete after pouring the water into the concrete materials. So you have to mix the concrete thoroughly, okay? Otherwise maybe the voids will form. This is the mixing procedure. This is the manual procedure. Otherwise we will use the machine also. So once the concrete is mixing is finished, you have to pour the slump cone in 4 layers, and by using the tamping rod you have to give the 25 blows at each layer. The length of the tamping rod is 0.6 meter and diameter is 16 mm diameter. So now once the concrete is finished, so you have to pour the concrete in the slump cone apparatus. So here, before pouring the concrete, here you have to apply the grease, and also you have to clean this one. Maybe any material is there inside, or any previous cement or cement particles are there, you have to remove that one by washing or cleaning with any help of towel or any other thing. So here, now you have to take the scoop. I will show you that one. This is a scoop. By using this scoop, you have to take the concrete here and you have to fill this one around 4 layers. At each layer, you have to apply the blows, that is around 25 blows into the tamping rod. If you observe here, this is the tamping rod. The diameter of this tamping rod is 16 mm and length of this tamping rod is 0.6 meter. Now, we are putting one tray here after this one. Okay. So now, we are pouring the concrete. Please observe this one. So each layer it is a 1/4 of total height of the slump cone. Okay, so first layer finished, we have to give the blows like this. So 25 blows are finished. Now we have to pour the concrete to the next level. So again apply the blows. The second layer finished. and also gloves due to pandemic situation. So this is the third layer. So once if you pour all the four layers, so you have to level the surface like this. And now once if it is finished, remove the nuts whatever available here, then you have to uplift the frustum. Now we are uplifting this one to know the workability of concrete. You have to remove this, uplift this one slowly. Yeah. So now we have to calculate the slump value like this. From here, use the scale, or in the site also we use directly like this. Okay? Maybe we will calculate like this and we will take the reading here. Otherwise, there is one more procedure. So like this, we have to measure this one. Okay? So here we got around 70 mm of a slump value. So this is called, we have three types of the slumps are there. The first one is true slump, second one is shear slump, and third one is collapsible. So when the flow width is more, it will collapse. When normal purpose, it is like a true slump, and sometimes it is shear. The value, so once the slump values, whatever we got here, if it is the slump value is 25 to 75, the slump, we call it as a low workability, okay? And it is used for the mass concrete and also lightly reinforced concrete. And the slump value is 50 to 100, it is a medium workability, that means medium slump, we used for the heavy reinforced concrete. And if it is slump value is 100 to 150, it is high workability, we used for the trench and in situ piling. If it is greater than 150 mm, it is very high, we used for the temporary works. So this is complete procedure for the slump contest. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any doubts, contact me.